Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. In the last part, we entered the first world of the game, Mayhem Temple. And in this part, we'll be getting to the meat and potatoes of the world. Last part, we pretty much got all the basic stuff down. And this one, we're going to get some more things going. And hopefully, getting that much closer to 100%ing this world. Because if you've not watched my Banjo-Kazooie one, I will be 100%ing this Let's Play. Or this game, I should say. And, let's see, prison compound. Was I supposed to go in here? I wanted to learn that move, but... Wait. I don't know how to move yet. Yeah, cheese and rice. I don't have that move yet. The plan was to not do that and was to go into a different room. I guess I got these confused because this was right on the way, so... Whoops, sorry about that. I'm just winging it right there. Okay, Kazooie can probably vouch for me with that. So yes, the plan is to actually go in that door and learn that certain move, because learning the, as you can see, there's ledges, I might as well say it, learning the grip grab move is basically one of the more important moves in the game, and if you don't have it, you can basically be shut out of many, many, many things, because each world basically applies using it. So this is Jade Snake Grove. This is where I want to go. Not the prison compound yet, but with this we got the warp head done. And let's interact. We got 35 notes. We can learn this move. Grip grab. Listen up to what you're told. On the edges you can now hold. Move along with the greatest of ease. Button to X attack. Please. Please. That'll be all. Dismissed. Ah. Aw, oh, man. I'm waiting, Jam Jars. You're gonna slip up one of these days. And there he goes, Orange Ginger, okay. And I think that's the guy that tell you need a statue over there. And there's another warp actually over here. Let's see what we got here. Got a little juncture over here. We got like a four direction kind of thing, or three directions. And we actually have a tent over here. Let's get this globo. Not yet, I'm gonna hold up. I just wanna do a couple more things with Banjo-Kazooie before I go into there, because that's a new character in this game that will be aiding us throughout our adventure. But first, that's the only thing I forgot to do with the statue is kick that open. I'll do that eventually. It's not really important, that room, so it's not really important yet, because it involves something with the Cheeto pages, so we don't have any Cheeto pages really, so eh. And if we walk on the vine, oh god, he swallowed it. Thought he would steal Slumber's gold while he slept, did you? Well, yes, to be honest. But I heard you coming, clumsy bear. Oh. Aw, please don't be like Jafar. I don't want to know how snake-like you can be. Splendid, they seem to have gone. Must get some more sleep. Alright, so in this game, there's a lot more stealth missions. I don't even think there was a stealth mission in the last one, but you want to be very... Oh, okay, that wasn't very quiet, Banjo, but if you mess up, he spits it out and goes back to sleep, so no harm, no foul. But yes, if you ever see vines, you gotta go very slow. There we go. Can't make a sound. Gotta tiptoe. Banjo. Solid Snake Banjo right here. Banjo? Banjo? Banjo! It actually makes sense right here. We're getting this jiggy from a snake, so that actually was a solid snake reference that was actually relevant, so cool. And we can grip grab over here. So basically, if you see a ledge that has like a line like this, it's obvious. And watch out for these yellow dunes. Oh god, okay, I didn't want to get that. Thank god I missed it. If you see these yellow dunes, be prepared for an enemy to stick out. They're pretty much the, what were they called? Chungas? Chungos? Those things in the Clanker's Cavern that put their head out. Those kind of enemies. Oh, I thought you would survive that, Banjo. I'm sorry. Okay, let's get the non-exclamation point one. There we go. And we're full of health again, and yes, we learned that move. Basically, that'll be very useful in doing everything pretty much in Mayhem Temple. So now we know that, and we got that jiggy from that snake, we can actually move out from here, and I think it actually is a good time to visit that tent and see what that character is all about. Guessing she's kind of Native American, or he is a kind of Native American. Okay, it's a she. This is Wumba's Wigwam. Wait, well, I'm not a tent. Big heap wubblegum to little bear and bird. I'm Banjo, my feather friend is Kazooie. Me Humba Wumba, best magic person on island. We heard that Mumbo was the best. Not true. Mumbo amateur. Mumbo's best. You bring Globo magic creatures here. You have Globo? Want to give Humba to Humba? Yes, we will give you that Globo, Humba. Wumba, whatever your name is, Jumbo. Sure, I'll just throw it in. Whoa! We just drowned that thing. Magic ready, jump in Wumba pool. I don't know, man. It's glowing with purple fizz. My doctor told me not to jump into any dangerous-looking purple-ish goop kind of things. I'm just gonna leave now. Okay, I'll jump in. I regret this immediately. Oh, we still have a little globo to sacrifice, but there we go, we transform. And a Wumbo called this Stony. Use left stick to move and press B to, for big heap per bam attack, whatever she said. Jump back in Wumbo Poo then when want to be Bear and Bird again. And basically I'll just throw this out right here. This is the Stony, the first transformation in the game. Wumba pretty much transforms you different creatures throughout the game, so she's pretty much Mumbo in the last game. And the main point I was trying to make was, basically, you can use her powers anytime. If you saw the globo come out, that doesn't mean anything. Each round is unlimited. The same thing with Mumbo. And what we want to do is actually take you to the prison compound. We'll do the prison compound first, then we'll do the kickball tournament, because that's what they said only would be allowed in there. So let's right here, whoops, I actually hit my mic scratching myself. Let's talk to this gentleman right here. I think he'll understand us now. To free the trapped one, the sun must rise before the moon and the star. Sun, moon, star, moon, sun. 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 Sun, moon, star. Sun, moon, star, moon, sun. There we go, okay. I'm sorry if that was really annoying. I have very bad short-term memory, and saying that repeatedly actually helped. And, hey, it's a mole. Hello, little rabbit friend. Eek, Mitoberta was out looking for gold when that boulder fell down and trapped me in here. I suppose you expect us to move it? Eek, if you wouldn't mind. We actually can't move this yet. We don't know a certain move. We have to learn that in the next world. Basically, you'll find out in Banjo-Tooie, there's a lot of backtracking among the worlds. Kazooie was a minor offender of that, as it only did it once, and that was only in Freeze Easy Peak and Gobi's Valley with the running shoes. And so yeah, and that wasn't that big of a, that much of a big of a deal. Yeah, that made sense. And if we can fit through here, we can fit through tiny spaces with the Stony, and that is a empty honeycomb. This is an extra piece. I'll explain it. Empty honeycombs basically restore or give you an extra gauge of life. You collect a certain amount of them, but we only have one, so that's not going to do us any good. And we don't know where to bring them, so you have to bring them somewhere in this game. And as you can see, the Stony's pretty slow, so that's why the warp pads are a godsend in this game. Alright, so we're gonna make our way to the kickball tournament because this guy said only Stonies were allowed, and hey, we're a Stony, but we're in a backpack and shorts. I think that someone would point us out in a line right here, but let's see what happens. I'm Banjo the Stony. Sorry about that. Apparently, my game capture device wanted to join Banjo's experience in being stoned, but anyway, let's talk to this big cat again, video glitches aside, and finally set this straight. I'm Banjo the Stony. Can I come in and play? I don't know. That backpack looks kind of familiar. Are you saying we're a bear and bird in an elaborate disguise, trying to cheat our way in? Yep, it's pretty obvious, but they're a bit short on players, so you might as well go in anyway. Wow, okay, technicalities for the win! We can gain entry even though the guy called us out, and we're in the Mayan Kickball Stadium. There's a warp pad, pretty useful for later on. And a training area if you don't know how to play Mayan kickball, which is actually much different than your schoolyard game of kickball, as we will see. Welcome to the Mayan Amateur Kickball Championship. You may enter the quarterfinals, but I advise you to take a little training downstairs first. Okay, apparently this guy gets his voice acting from Tristan from Yu-Gi-Oh! The Abridged series. I don't know. I guess we'll go with that. And here we go, the Mayan Kickball Quarterfinal. Got some baddies we gotta play against. We got a red guy, yellow guy, and a purple guy. Hey, Wok, who's this ugly new guy? Well, which one's Wok? Is it the purple one or the yellow one? Who's Wok? Who's on first? Okay. Alright, so basically, the quarterfinal round is the easiest round, obviously, as all you have to do is worry about the yellow balls going into your net. Nothing else? Nothing else, okay. So you can pretty much just crush them right here. There's really no skill to this. All you have to do is just walk around, grab the ball, and shoot it with RT. Just know that it has a limited range. You pretty much can only shoot up until, like, almost half court, but you may have to push it in after that. You can actually dive with the ball. You can travel, obviously, not just straight up dribble, so hitting X a lot actually makes it go faster. I don't really do that. I just kind of walk it out, you know what I'm saying? But look at that. We got 5 seconds left, and we put up a 26 spot. Like, look at that, 004. Easy enough, right? You've won your quarterfinal. Move on to the semifinals. We will indeed. Okay, so we got the right door to go in this time. Hopefully, we'll do as good as we did in the first round. Hopefully, it'll be a little bit more of a challenge, though. It's kind of boring. But here we go. Mayan kickball semifinal. Those shorts look stupid. You know what? You look stupid. You're naked. Ha! May the best Stony win! Okay, so now we're introduced to red balls. Basically, red balls are -1 point. And you can shoot them. That basically, you want to shoot the red balls into the opposing nets, and the yellow ones still go in your net. And like I said, the red balls take off 1 point, so slightly harder, but yeah, you can actually put some skill and some strategy into this, but if you just focus on getting the yellows, they shouldn't overpower you too much, because they actually, believe it or not, actually play for themselves. They don't, like, play against you, because I don't know, that would be quite unfair having a 3-on-1, but... Ooh, okay, and basically, little thing right there is that almost missed. If it hits the sides of the net, it will shatter, and it will not count. So you gotta make sure it goes right in the net, and there we go! 17 points, okay, at least got full 4-on-1. A little better, at least they're improving as a team. You've won your semi-final! The Lion Kickball Final beckons! Beckons? Snake? Okay. We already saw enough snakes in this part. Let's move on to the middle one, the last one, the finals. Mayan Kickball Final. We're still playing the same people, that's kind of weird. You've no chance of becoming champion. What do you guys do? May the best Stony win! Alright, yeah, how do these guys have a chance? But anyway, 45 seconds on the clock. Ready, set, go. And, yeah, I know it's out there. But, yes, we have bombs now introduced. Bombs? Yes, we have to bomb us some... Dongomines, yeah. Just rolls right off the tongue. But yeah, the bombs can obviously, like I showed before, they can take out a group, and it's pretty effective, but I actually lost like once or twice in the finals in my practice file because I would spend too much time trying to bomb my opponents and score on my net, because they actually creep up on you and score, so you just gotta make sure, like, you have to always look at your second place guy and be like, go for the red one instead of the yellow sometimes. Like, I'm just putting a couple in the purple spot, and look at that, we won. Only with a score of 9, but you just gotta make sure you win. I declare you the new Mayan Kickball Champion! I'm too choked up for words. Kazooie, you're such an asshole. That's why we love you, kid. That's why we love you. But yes, that's our 7th G. Awesome. Lots of progress. We actually want to change back, I believe. We want to go back to Wumba's Wigwam and change back because I would end it here, but there's actually two things I want to grab before we end the part. And I think it would be better use of my time to do them now and extend a little. I don't know. We're up to like 13:30 right now, but if we make it to like 15, 16, that's not going to hurt us, right? You guys want to see as much footage as possible. This is like delayed a day or two, so... This is my way of saying I'm sorry and I apologize, so. And basically, Wumba say that her magic is basically free now. We can go in there anytime. That applies to the whole game, and so does Mumbo. I think I mentioned that. Alright, so now that we're Banjo and Kazooie this time around, we can actually do what I wanted to do. Let's go to the world, world entry, yeah. We want to go to the fly pad. Remember how I said that was going to be a useful little trinket that we unlocked in the last part? This is how it's going to be useful. Basically, we can reach any area in the world, and this world is really small when you think about it. Compared to Mumbo's Mountain, I think it's even smaller. There's just a lot of things to do inside. But heck, it's a nice world one. It's better than the next world. I actually like it much better than the next world. The next world is actually not one of my favorites, but oh well, it's a little confusing. And there's one thing that I hate in that world. It's one of the Jiggy missions, but we'll get into that later. Let's just beak bomb our way to the second thing we want to get, and... What the? Did I just get rejected by an invisible wall? What the hell, man? Okay, I didn't think they would actually have that in the 360 version. I think they would fix that, but... Oh well, we didn't even need the Crypt Grab move to even get to that. We can just fly to it. So yeah, the grip grab is convenient, but with the fly pad, that's kind of pointless, but oh well, I sequence break, what are you gonna do? And let's just cross the bridge, and I think that we'll call it a part. That's what the next G will be. Yep, that's what I'll do, okay. Because I can't do it, obviously, in this part. That would be way too, that would be pushing it, really. That's all I wanted to say on that. And yes, so thank you guys for watching. Let's actually view our totals, but yeah, we're gonna tackle this G next. It could be, it's basically gonna be like the snake one. And let's just go view totals right here. We can use Jinjo's objects and whatnot. We have 5 Jiggies, 100 notes, 2 empty honeycombs, 1 Cheeto page, 2 Globos. We learned all the moves, and we're missing 1 Jinjo, which we'll be getting the next part. The next part, I'll have to really, like, pack it together, because we really have to cram a lot of stuff. We gotta cram 4 more Jiggies, because 1's not gettable, remember. So, yes, I'm really rambling right here. I will see you guys next time on Let's Play Banjo-Tooie, and be sure to leave a like, favorite, and share it around, and, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this part. I'll see you later, guys, and until next time.